It's the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for Saturday, the 11th of August. I'm Michael Graff. Kind of unusual to see storms in the valley during the monsoon on two consecutive nights, but how about four in a row? That was the case last night as we extended our streak. Another round of showers and storms moved in from the east and northeast, producing damaging winds, lots of downed trees and power lines, heavy rain, at least an inch in some spots. And yes, there was even some small hail with some of these storms. So, will we make it five in a row tonight? Well, let's find out as we get out there and talk about it. First of all, yesterday in the valley, 100 degrees the high, 72 the low at Sky Harbor. And that occurred during the peak of the storms in the 11 o'clock hour. Also, we set a daily record for August the 10th with 56 hundredths of an inch of rain in the bucket. Still, we're way behind on rainfall, so we could certainly use some more. And outside right now, here at 9:35 a.m., we've got partly cloudy skies in the valley, and we currently sit at 84 degrees out there. Dew points at 64, humidity 52%. Wind from the east at 11 miles per hour, and the barometer is steady. Temperatures across south central Arizona, most of us in the 80s at this hour. Water vapor satellite view, we've got a northeast to southwest oriented ridge here over the west. An area of low pressure across Texas and another trough over the Pacific Northwest, and that has given us an elevated northeasterly flow aloft, allowing storms to move off the mountains into the deserts, and that's still there today. The watch warning map, we have heat advisories and excessive heat warnings and fire danger risks across much of the Pacific Northwest and the Northern Rockies. Air pollution, a big problem in the Dakotas and Minnesota because of the wildfires over the west. They have air quality alerts. And in the northeast, we've got flash flood watches and flood advisories for many of the major hubs up in that region. Severe weather outlook for today, a marginal risk of severe storms along the middle Atlantic coast. And here in Arizona, a couple of marginal risk areas across west central and northwest Arizona. And just to our southeast, down toward Tucson and Nogales. You see, we are not in that risk, but doesn't mean we couldn't see some severe storms later today, but the conditions are not quite as favorable as they have been in recent days, which we'll discuss here momentarily. Rainfall for the next 7 days coming from the WPC amounts around 3/4 of an inch or so here in the valley, with heavier totals across the rim country and in far southern and southeast Arizona. Any one spot, obviously, is capable of seeing more than what is displayed here. So let's get out to the details of our weather now. Look at the models and see if we can go for five in a row tonight. Here we go to the GFS, the 06Z run valid at 5 o'clock this afternoon. Ridging extends from the Dakotas southwestward to the Great Basin and here across the southwest. Low pressure over Texas, an enhanced northeasterly flow aloft. A bit of drier air is making its way in from the northeast, however, especially at the upper levels, and that may help to put a bit of a cap on the atmosphere today. So down below all that at the surface, mostly sunny this morning, partly cloudy this afternoon, widely scattered showers and thunderstorms develop over the high country. Highs today in the valley between 98 and 102, and it'll still be muggy out there. But will storms get into the valley? Let's look at the high-res models and see what they say. The HRRR, which has performed brilliantly the last four nights, well, it's got nothing. I mean, this is crickets tonight at 8 o'clock, and the entire run shows nothing over the south central desert. Same thing for the NAM. It's very quiet this evening. So based on this alone, it would suggest that our chance of rain is practically zero, but it's the monsoon, and we do have at least some favorable conditions still in place with that northeast flow. So I guess we'll call for a 20% chance of seeing showers and storms here tonight. Otherwise, tonight will be partly cloudy with lows upper 70s to mid 80s. Tomorrow, mostly sunny in the morning, partly cloudy afternoon. Only a slight chance of seeing showers and storms here in the valley. Better chances over the higher terrain. Highs a bit warmer, 102 to 105. Around 103 to 106 with just a slight chance of showers and storms on Monday and Tuesday, as the monsoon moisture will be a little bit lower, but certainly still that chance will be with us. Wednesday, the GFS and the global models in general, the European, the GEM, all the models and the ensembles suggest an uptick in shower and thunderstorm activity beginning here, showing maybe a disturbance coming through, better east and southeasterly flow, more moisture in place. So an increasing chance of showers and storms, locally heavy rain possible Wednesday, Thursday, and Friday. The best window of opportunity will always be in the afternoon and evening hours, and it's hard to pick out which day will be the most active, but any one of these three, or perhaps even all three, could be. And high temperatures would be cooling off if that is the case. Highs back in the upper 90s to about 102. Here's a week from today. This is Saturday, the 18th of August, and I'll be very candid with you here. Forecast confidence goes way down out here toward next weekend. There's no consistency in the models. GFS shows ridging beginning to nudge off to the west over the Great Basin and along the west coast. Still a northeast flow, maybe a slight chance of showers and storms. Here's Sunday the 19th. Kind of showing a more amplified pattern with ridging building over the northeast Pacific and kind of a drier northwesterly flow beginning to develop here. And then the end of the forecast period, Monday the 20th, the GFS shows troughing across the northern Rockies, heading out into the central plain states, a big ridge extending all the way up into Alaska, and we'd be under northwesterly flow. Not so sure about this. The European has high pressure centered right over the Four Corners to continue our monsoon. So kind of got to go with a preponderance of the models and suggest that at least a low grade monsoon would likely continue all the way out here. But we will see. Let's check the temperatures through the period coming off of the GFS ensemble. Highs getting a bit warmer the next few days. And then overall, after that, highs will remain right around normal levels for mid to late August, with that daily chance of showers and storms looking to continue. And that's going to about wrap it up for the Phoenix, Arizona weather discussion for today. My next video back here tomorrow morning. If you like our videos, be sure to subscribe so that whenever we post a brand new one, you'll get the notifications. Plus, your comments, questions, suggestions, always welcome as well. Be safe, stay cool, drink plenty of water out there, and have a tremendous Saturday.